Sairam children, so today we are going to continue the previous day's chapter, which is Bipin Chaudhary's lapse of memory. And you know the meaning of lapse. Lapse means someone who is, there's been a gap. You have forgotten that part of the memory. Okay, fine. And as we had, we were on page number 65 and question number 4. Fine. Now, who wants to read the question? Pranjal, can you read the fourth question?
Yes. What did Mr. Mukherjee say? Did it comfort Bipin Babu or add to his worries?
And you know the answer? Do you know the answer? Ranjan? Anyone who wants to answer this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Parth, you can answer.
Ma'am, direct answer or question?
No, he has read the question, he tells the answer.
Okay. Mr. Mukherjee, after checking his diary, said that they had visited Ranchi in October 58. This added to Bipin Babu's worries, as he could not figure out how he could possibly have forgotten about the trip.
Okay, sorry, my mic was mute. Yes. Radhika, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read this question on page number 68. Who was Chunni Lal? That question.
Ma'am, may I read?
Yes, Rudraksh, you can read.
Who was Chunni Lal? What did he want from Bipin Babu?
Do you know the answer?
Ma'am, Chunni Lal was an old friend of Bipin Babu. He wanted a favor from Bipin Babu in his job.
Okay, in finding a job. Okay. And you can also write he was... You can also write he was Bipin Babu's schoolmate. And the other part of the answer was right. Okay, good. Next, Nipun.
Yes, ma'am.
Why was Dr. Chanda puzzled? What was unusual about Bipin Babu's loss of memory? Dr. Chanda was puzzled because he had never before dealt with such a case before and it was outside of his experience. The unusual thing about Bipin Babu's loss of memory that remembered all his past except of the trip to Ranchi.
Okay, good. Yes, do you want to try the next one also, Nikunj? Page number 70.
Yes, ma'am. Had Bipin Babu really lost his memory and forgotten all about a trip to Ranchi? No, Bipin Babu had not really lost his memory and forgotten all about a trip to Ranchi. It was a trick played by Chunnilal.
Prank. It's a prank. Yes. And it was actually a prank played by this schoolmate Chunnilal, who wanted to punish Bipin Babu for his selfishness. Okay? Yes. The second one, who wants to do the second one of page 70?
Ma'am?
Yes, Pooja, you may do it.
Yes, ma'am.
Next one.
Ma'am, may I read?
One second. After Pooja, it's Nandini, and after Nandini, it's Radhika. Okay?
Yes, ma'am. Why do you think Chunnilal did what he did? Chunnilal says he has no money. What is it that he does have? Answer. Chunnilal was hurt by the way Bipin Babu had ignored his request for help in his bad times. He expected an old friend to show more sympathy and there is need of Bipin Babu. In order to teach Bipin Babu a lesson, Chunnilal decided to put him through some discomfort by convincing him he had lost his memory. This is why he did what he did.
Okay. Fine. Anyone else who can give a different answer in his or her own words? Anyone wants to attempt the same question? Answer, only answer.
Ma'am, the second question?
Yes.
Ma'am, Chunnilal did what he did because Bipin Babu didn't help him when he was in need.
Didn't help him, huh? You can also write that when Chunnilal approached Bipin Babu for help in his bad times, Bipin Babu did nothing for him. And that too for an old friend of his in finding a job. In fact, he thought of Chunnilal as an old penny, if you see it there in the chapter, and got irritated every time Chunnilal visited him. And that was the reason why Chunnilal might not have, he didn't have money or a job, but what he did was actually an imagination. And he used to punish, he wanted to punish Bipin Babu for his insensitive behavior. So this is another way of putting it, okay? Yes. Nikunj, anything else you want to add?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Next, it was Nandini. Working with the text. First one, Nandini.
Ma'am, may I answer?
Yes, Nandini, what did you say?
Ma'am, can I answer fourth answer?
Fourth answer. We are doing the first one of working with the text.
Ma'am, may I?
Ma'am, may I?
Okay, one second, beta. Akshat, you can try this first one with the answer.
The author described Bipin Babu as a serious, as a hardworking man. What evidence can you find? The author has described Bipin Babu as a serious, hardworking man. He worked daily in his office. It was a big
yes. Yes, Akshat, you can try. I think this has got some net problem. Akshata, you can say the same answer.
Yes, ma'am. Bipin Babu was described as a serious and hardworking man. He was working daily in his office. It was a big firm and he was doing a responsible job. He had been associated in this firm for the past 25 years.
Oh, good. He was a very known to be very tireless also. A tireless means a person who doesn't get tired. He doesn't show that he's tired and he keeps working. Okay. Next, who was it? Radhika? You also wanted to attempt now. Why don't you go for the second one? Why did Bipin Babu change his mind? That one. Are you there, Radhika? Yes, Akshat, if you are back, you can try the second one.
Why did Bipin Babu change his mind about meeting Chunnilal? What was the result of this meeting? Bipin Babu changed his mind about meeting Chunnilal because he thought that it might be possible that the latter remembered something about the Ranchi trip. When Chunnilal confirmed that Bipin Babu had been to Ranchi, Bipin Babu decided to see a specialist doctor.
Okay. Anyone else? Good, very good, Akshat. Anyone else who has to add something to this? Parth, you want to try this? Second one again?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Chunnilal had come to visit as usual to remind him about his job, whom Bipin Babu avoid to meet. But that day, he changed his mind and met Chunnilal. He thought that it might be possible that the latter remember something about the Ranchi trip. Chunnilal confirmed that Bipin Babu had been to Ranchi. Not able to get any solution to his problem, Bipin Babu decided to see a specialist doctor for the treatment of his memory loss.
Okay. Here you can also mention that Chunnilal told him that indeed he had gone to Ranchi, and for that he made his travel arrangements. He had also got the fan in his train apartment fixed. This completely made him even more confused, Bipin Babu, when he told little things about it. Okay, so this way you can enlarge the question answer also. Fine, both of you, very good. Yes, third one, who is going to do? Devang, have you taken out the answers?
Ma'am.
If no one is there, then I'll tell. Adhyasha, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you still, have you come back here to Gale?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And you're in the campus only now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So now you have a textbook now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can you try the third one? Of working with the text.
Yes.
Page.
Bipin Babu lost consciousness at Pudru Falls. What do you think was the reason for this?
Yes, you know the answer?
No, ma'am.
Okay, fine. You can mute your mic. Anyone else who wants to try this? Tanisha?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, try the third one. It's a long answer, actually, everyone. Listen carefully.
Bipin Babu lost consciousness at Hudru Falls because he had a fall. He had broken his hip.
That's it.
Yes,
ma'am. Oh no, it's a very long answer. You have to write it in detail what happened over there near the falls.
Yes, ma'am, Pooja. Can I try?
Yes, Pooja. Tanisha Graham, you tell. Pooja,
Yes, ma'am. Bipin Babu was already in very disturbed state of mind during his Ranchi visit because he could not remember a single thing about the place which would signal a return of his memory. He visited Hudru Falls to see if he would remember it, for it was here that he was told he did hurt his knee. Having no recollection of the place, he must have become more hopeless and must have slept and fallen on a bladder and become unconscious by the impact.
Okay. Fine. Good. If I have to write it even more in detail, I would go for the thing that, as Pooja said, that Bipin Babu was already under a lot of stress. Okay? Since the time he met Parimal Ghosh in the bookshop. He had tried to clear the confusion in his mind by checking with two of his friends, Chunni Lal and Dinesh Mukherjee. But both had collaborated with Parimal Ghosh's story, means they had agreed with the story. Bipin Babu had a case of insanity in his family. Insanity means, jaise pagalpan hota hai, there's some problem with the brain, and so he was worried about himself also, because you start feeling that hame to nahi ho jayega kahin agar family mein kisi ko dimag ki bimari hai, to we start thinking that, oh, probably when I have started getting that. He thought that he was losing his mind. So he started believing that, yes, probably when I am having that problem, what some other member of the family is having. And when Dr. Chandra suggested that he should go to Ranchi, as it might bring back the memory, he saw a ray of hope. But he thought, okay, probably now is my chance to get back my memory. But when he reached Ranchi, he realized that he had never been there. And the distress and dismay had a great impact on him and he fell unconscious. So all this mental stress and this dismay actually made him unconscious. Okay, yes. Now the last question, who is going to do?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes.
Ma'am, I have to first call the question.
Yes, yes, read the question.
Yes. How do you think Bipin Babu reacted when he found out that Chunni Lal has tricked him? Answer. Bipin Babu was shocked, dumbfounded and embarrassed when he found out that Chunni Lal has tricked him.
Okay, actually this is also a long answer to write it in detail. Anyone else? Yes, Akshat?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, answer only.
Yes, yes.
After finding out that Chunni Lal had tricked him, Bipin Babu must have been filled with sadness towards an old friend who needs his help. He would have realized that he had done wrong with his friend. Forgot the meaning of friendship.
Okay. Good. Okay, someone in the chat box has asked me, what is the meaning of consciousness? Now, consciousness means that actually it is, hum log conscious hai. If you see that, what is unconscious, hum log kehte hain, this person became unconscious. Matlab wo behosh ho gaya. And conscious hona matlab hosh mein rehna, being aware of your surroundings, basically. Conscious means being around, aware of your surroundings. So it is that state of mind where you are aware of your surroundings. Okay, that is conscious. And in Hindi, it seems chetna. Just, I checked it out. It's worth showing that it's chetna. Fine. So this is over, the question answers part of it. Now working with the language, fill in the blanks. Who is going to read from fill in the blanks? Pranjal, are you there? Have you done any work? Pranjal, if you're there, please read this page number 71. Fill in the blanks using had to, have to, and has to.
Yes, sir. First, no?
Yes. All, but all you start reading and start filling the answer also.
Yes, ma'am. First, ma'am, I dash cut my hair every month. I have to cut my hair every month.
Okay, good. Next.
We dash go for swimming lessons last year. We had to go for swimming lessons last year.
Yes, very good. As it is past tense. Okay. Third one.
She dash tell the principal the truth. She has to tell the principal the truth.
Very good, very good.
They dash take the baby to the doctor. They have to take the baby to the doctor.
No, they had to. Here it will be had.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, next.
We dash complain to the police about the noise. We have to complain to the police about the noise.
Very good.
Six. Romit dash finish his homework before he could come out to play. Romit had to finish his homework before he could come out to play.
Good, good.
I dash repair my cycle yesterday. I had to repair my cycle yesterday.
Excellent, excellent. Now I'll just do this. I've got this nod extension. I'll do this some clapping for you people. For all the ones who have given the answers and for Pranjal also. All of you. Today is very nice. I found the class very participative. Excellent. Very good. Now, next one, idioms one, Parth, would you like to read this question, second one? Parth, are you there? Oh, I think there's some problem in the net. So, anyone else who would like to do? Netik? Shriyansh, Rohit, Mudit. Mudit, can you try the second one? Akshita, if you're there, you can read this question, the second one. Of working with the language. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Because many of them are suddenly leaving the class and then rejoining. Tanisha, just read the second one. Here are a few idioms.
Study the sentences in the column below. E. I saw this movie yesterday.
Previous one, Tanisha. Second one.
Ma'am, it is blur in my book, ma'am. The second part.
Okay, then you do the third one.
Study the sentences in the column below. I saw this movie yesterday. Bipin Babu worked here for last year. Chunnilal wrote to a publisher last week. I visited Ranchi once long ago. Column B. I have seen this movie already. Bipin Babu has worked here since 2003. Chunnilal has written to a publisher. I have visited Ranchi once before. Compare the sentences in the two columns, especially the verb form. Answer the following question about each pair of sentences. Which column tells us the Bipin Babu is still working at the same place? Answer column B.
Yes, column B.
And B2.
Okay, B2, yes. Next.
Which column suggests that Chunilal is now waiting for a reply for a publisher? Column A. Which column suggests...
No, I think it's column 2 only. Sorry, B, B. The column suggests that Chunilal is now waiting for a reply. He's waiting for a reply, no? This,
yes, ma'am. Ma'am, the third one.
B. Yes, the third one of column B. Okay, so the, here also the answer is B. Okay, next, Tanisha.
Which column suggests that the person still remembers the movie he saw? Column B.
Yes, good. Last one.
Yes, ma'am.
Last one. This column suggests that.
Which column suggests that the experience of visiting Ranji is still fresh in the speaker's mind? Column B.
No, it's actually A. This, yeah, here it is A. Okay, so all 1, 2, 3 is B and the last one is A. Okay, good. Now, the second one was left. Thank you, Tanisha. Nikanj, would you like to try the second one?
Yes, ma'am. Here are few idioms that you will find in the story. Idioms that you will find in the story. Look for them in the dictionary in the following way. First, arrange them in the order in which you would find them in a dictionary. Clue: an idiom is usually listed under the first noun, verb, adjective, or adverb in it. Ignore articles or prepositions in the idiom. To help you, we have put in bold the word under which you must look for the idiom in the dictionary. First, at, from, close quarters. Close adjective. Ma'am, short distance.
Yes, yes, very good.
Break into a smile, laugh suddenly.
Laugh suddenly, okay.
Carry on, continue.
It's a verb. Huh?
Have a clean record. Have, ma'am, I don't know this one.
You may find actually the related meanings under both these words. You can find under clean also and under record also. Fine, do go for the next one.
Beat about the bush, not straightforward.
And it's a verb. Beat is a verb.
Yes, ma'am.
So where is it used usually, beat about the bush? Anyone who wants to give an example? You must have heard this many times.
Ma'am, like someone is not going straight on the yes. talk, ma'am, that they are wanted to talk.
Yes, matlab wo ghuma fira rahe hain, basically. Beat about the bush.
Yes,
like discussing a matter without coming to the point. Matlab aap yahan ki maroge, wahan ki maroge, but actual jo mudda hai, usko nahi aap face kar rahe. You're not addressing the actual thing what's been asked, but idhar ki udhar ki maar rahe ho. Certain people have this nature, you can see. People around you also. So that is actually called beating the bush. Okay? Like if you say examples, you can say like, if you want to ask me, just ask. Don't beat about the bush. Matlab jo puchna hai wo saaf saaf poocho samne se. Idhar ki udhar ki mat maro. Even it can be other way, both ways. Okay? Fine. Now the second one is also over and we'll go for the fourth one. We have jumble sentences over here. Yes, who would like to read this? Akshata, do you want to read? Or Radhika, anyone? Am I audible? Yes, Akshita has just joined. Pranjal or Radhika, anyone? Radhika is also, I suppose, left. Sarthak, are you there? Who's going to do the fourth one?
Ma'am, can I?
Yes. Yes, better. Pranjal.
Ma'am?
Do better. The fourth one given below. Read that.
Yes, ma'am. From starting?
Yes, yes, from the starting.
Given below are jumbled sentences. Working in groups, rearrange the words in the each sentence to form correct sentences. You will find that each sentence contains an idiomatic expressions that you have come across in the lesson. Underline the item and write down its meaning. Then use your dictionary to check the meaning. One sentence has been worked out for you as an example.
Okay.
Jumble sentences. First one.
Yes, yes. Tell the answer for the first one.
Vanished into thin air.
Actually, you have to change it a little bit.
From the car seemed to have vanished into thin air.
That's the first one.
Ma'am, it's the example.
Yeah, I'm not talking about the example. I'm talking about the exercise. First one. Nikunj, would you like to try?
I'm beating about the bush.
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Ma'am, stop beating about the bush and tell me what you want.
Yes, exactly. Stop beating about the bush and tell me what you want. That's the answer. Everyone note it down. Stop beating about the bush and tell me what you want. Yes. And the idiom is beat about the bush. That means to talk irrelevantly. That just say, koi concern nahi hai, nata nahi hai, wo bol rahe ho. Yes, second one, who would like to try? Pranjali, you want to try?
Yes, ma'am. If you don't pay attention to the announcement, you might board the wrong train.
Very good.
Pay attention.
Yes, the idiom is pay attention. And what does it mean? Listen carefully.
Yes,
now,
ma'am.
You people are paying attention, na? So you're listening carefully. Good. Yes. Third one.
Tried to pin the crime on the young woman.
Very good.
Pin the crime on.
Pin the crime.
Yes, pin the crime. And what's the meaning? Pin the crime in? Yes.
For something.
Galat person
and place the responsibility of the crime.
Yes. To blame someone for something. Matlab aap log tag kar dete na, jaise you just pin someone. पिन संबंध मतलब आपको पता है क्या होता है कि उसको पिन कर दिया मतलब जैसे उसी ने किया है विदाउट इवन नोइंग द फैक्ट्स सो पिन संबंध मींस टू ब्लेम समवन फॉर समथिंग यस फोर्थ वन
विपिन बाबू लव्ड टेलिंग पीपल दैट ही वाज अंडर डॉक्टर्स ऑर्डर टू ईट अर्ली अंडर वंस ऑर्डर
Yes, under doctor's orders. Okay. And what's the meaning of that? Under
specific instructions.
Yes. It's actually basically under treatment. Doctor's orders means you're under treatment. I hope you must be remembering this Saida's chapter of supplementary class 6. You remember her mother was under doctor's orders. To be confined going to be confined in the room. Doctor's order, मतलब डॉक्टर ने कहा जो कहा है वही करेंगे. So you are under treatment of the doctor. Fine. Last one, Pranjal.
The teacher raised his eyebrows when the students said that they had revised all their lessons.
Yes.
Raised the eyebrows.
Raised his eyebrows. So what does it mean? When do you raise your eyebrows?
Ma'am, being surprised.
Ma'am, to express surprise or doubt.
Very good. To express and obviously it's not, we use it for the dance and all also. For expressions, I'm not talking about the dance form. Okay, so we have completed this. We'll have a brief this one. When is your next class? It's I think on Thursday, na?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Akshita, I'm giving you this job. Once again, I just stopped the recording. What I was saying was just remind me that I have to take a Google form test quiz sort of from this chapter, okay, of this Bipin Babu, okay, and Thursday. So you remind me on Wednesday on my personal window, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then bye, all of you. Sai Ram, and you come.
Sai Ram.
Yes, you can come. Comprehension and this working with the text in the classwork. Grammar we have discussed already.
Sairam, ma'am.
Sairam, ma'am.
Sairam, ma'am.